We're back.
Yes, you're supposed to say hi, everybody.
Oh, well, I was getting around to that, Ralph. You didn't give me enough time. Hi, everybody, and welcome. This is the Susan Raye Show with our special guest star, Ralph Emery.
And it's brought to you by...
And it's brought to you by Bayer Aspirin and Ford Tough Trucks.
Very good, Susan.
Thank you.
Would you care, just since you have the mic and the records, go right ahead.
No, that's all right.
No, you go right ahead. Play the first one.
Well, all right. We'll just breeze on into a little Southern Nights with Glenn Campbell.
Southern Nights. Have you ever felt a Southern Night? Free as a breeze, not to mention the trees. Whistling tunes that you know and love so. Southern nights, just as good even when closed your eyes. I apologize to anyone who can truly say that he has found a better way. Southern sky. Well, its precious beauty lies just beyond the eye. It goes running through the soul like the stories told of old. Old man, he and his dog that walked the old land. Every flower touched his cold hand.
Who did you say that was?
I said it was Glenn Campbell.
Glenn.
Well, I've been in Nashville for 2 days now.
Glenn Campbell and the hit Southern Nights.
Now this from Sunrise 6 Productions.
The superstars of country music, 20 of the very best of the million sellers, such stars as Billy Crash Craddock.
Oh, my darling, knock 3 times on the ceiling if you want.
Johnny Cash.
Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Don Williams.
In the shelter of your eyes.
Tommy Overstreet.
When, how can I face her?
Sammy Smith.
Help me make it through the night.
You'll also get the Statler Brothers, Roy Clark, Tom T. Hall, Donna Fargo, and Johnny Rodriguez. 20 superstar artists in all. To order yours, send $4.95 to Country Lovin', Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202. That's Country Lovin', Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202. When someone in our house has a cold or flu and wants relief from the aches and fever, it's Rest, Fluids, and Bayer Aspirin. In my parents' house, it was Rest, Fluids, Bayer Aspirin. In my grandparents' house, it was Rest,
fluids, Bayer aspirin. Isn't it amazing? In over 60 years, medical science hasn't been able to improve upon aspirin. Three generations of doctors have recommended it. Bayer was the first aspirin, and today Bayer is still number one. Use only as directed. Tacky Susan Raye is my guest, who has to say to me,
it's catching,
upon hearing my commercial for Bayer aspirin, and I mentioned that my grandparents used to use it, she said, do they have aspirin that far back? Sure they did.
Well, I wasn't there.
Susan, welcome back to our show.
Well,
I think.
Why don't you sing? Why not?
No, you missed the point of the question. When you make records, why don't you sing?
Well, I've been thinking about it, seriously.
Wasn't this an old Connie Francis hit?
Yes.
And you revived it a few years ago.
Well, let's say I re-sang it.
All right. Whatever you say. Here is the lovely. I love that. Who tagged you with the lovely Susan Raye the first time?
I'll be darned if I know, and if I could find out who he was.
That's always been your handle. And here she is, the lovely Susan Raye. Never the pretty, the beautiful.
No. Talented? No.
Just the lovely. All right, no. Sing for us, lovely.
I told this heart of mine our love could never be. But then I hear your voice and something stirs inside of me.
Lovely, beautiful, and talented, says here on the paper, Susan Raye with My Heart Has a Mind of Its Own. Let me ask you about what I call the Bakersfield breakup. What has happened, for instance, to Buddy Allen and Tony Booth and LaWanda Lindsay, all those people who used to be with you in the Buck Owens show, and I don't hear anything about them anymore.
Well, when Buck Owens left Capitol Records, he took everyone along with him because we were all under contract to him rather than to the record label. So everyone has kind of gone different ways. Tony Booth has just signed with United Artists also.
The same label you are on.
Right. And LaWanda, I believe, just signed with Mercury.
Okay.
And I don't believe Buddy has signed with anyone yet.
Good kid. Like Buddy very much.
Yes.
What, is he looking for a record label to sing for?
I believe he is. I think he just cut a session last couple of weeks ago, and I think they're, sending it around and trying to find a place to place him and figure out where he's going to go.
Well, then I assume also that in the physical structure of the Buck Owens Road Show, that's been changed as well.
It has. For a long time, I had been the only one on the show, for the last couple of years at least. And then, actually, I haven't been on the show. I've done, I think, one Buck Owens show in the last year. He's just been going out on his own, and I've been going out on my own.
Now, your husband, Jerry Wiggins, still plays. He's still the drummer with Buck.
Right.
And has been for how many years?
10 years.
So he's still a buckaroo.
Right.
But I know that in the old days, I say the old days, maybe 5 years ago, 4 years ago, Buck would sing, and all of you folks would precede him and sing, and then you would come back and be his backup voices, I guess.
Yeah. That's all changed.
LaWanda, LaWanda, Tony, Buddy, and you. Am mm-hmm. I leaving anybody out?
Well, years ago, the Hagers used to be on the show,
right.
And then they had the Bakersfield Brass and several others. But he had kind of gotten away from that anyway in the past few years, and then he's just more or less gone out on his own.
So you
in
do
the
not,
last year.
You don't sing with Buck Owens anymore?
No.
Don't
of course,
work.
We're on different record labels. And
But you don't sing as a part of his show?
No.
Still under contract to him?
Well, somewhat. Some of my contracts have become, you know, run out.
But so essentially, you're doing you're in show business. You're just doing the Susan Raye show.
Right.
Okay.
I've been working on my own.
All right. I just wanted to establish that.
Just wanted to clarify things.
Right. Now here's Johnny Carver.
Well, I'm on my way to the city lights, to the pretty place that shines a light on the city nights. And I gotta get to noon train, I gotta be there on time. Oh, it feels so good to know she waits at the end of the line. Sweet, sweet city woman, I can see your face, I can hear your voice, I can almost touch you. Sweet, sweet city woman, oh, my banjo and me, we've got a feel for singing. Yeah, yeah. Pop, shabop, pop, pop, shabop, pop, pop, shabop, pop, 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 shabop, pop, pop, shabop, pop, pop, shabop, pop, 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 pop. So long, ma, so long, pa, so long, neighbors and friends. On a country morning, all covered in dew, it's just got a way to make a man feel shiny and new. And she sings in the evening old familiar tunes, and she feeds me loving tenderness and macaroons. Sweet, sweet city woman, I can see your face, I can hear your voice, I can almost touch you. Sweet, sweet city woman, oh, my banjo and me, we've got a feel for singing.
Johnny Carver once told me he was the only guy he ever knew who OD'd on Coke, Coca-Cola.
Mm.
He said he got into a Coke drinking contest one time.
Uh-huh.
And this is where you have a partner who feeds it to you.
So that when you become and so he too said far he, gone to drink yeah, it, they can still pour it down.
He drank so many, he passed out. You've heard Johnny Carver sings Sweet City Woman.
Here's Merle Haggard and big news about Ford pickup gas mileage.
Hey, pickup driving man, are you in love? Ford's got your kind of a real tough truck. It's a strong running, long running, smooth as a song running pickup with a proud Ford brand. Made tough for the pickup driving man.
Whatever you pick, you've got yourself one tough truck when you own a Ford F-150. Just how tough? Well, 93 out of 100 of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years are still on the job. Compared to our nearest competitor, a higher percentage of Ford trucks are still out there running after 12 years, 13, 14, even after 15 years. So get yourself down to your Ford dealer and check out that F-150. Susan, how long since you sat behind a turntable and played disc jockey?
Well, since I did it on an everyday basis, it's been about 12, 13 years.
You were in Oregon, weren't you?
Right.
Did you operate the board, what we call a board, with all the knobs and switches?
Yes, but we didn't have very many knobs and switches. It was a small station.
Well, small stations can have big boards.
Well, this one didn't. I did everything. We didn't even have the tape cartridges. I did all the commercials, and they locked me in there, was what it amounted to, for 4 hours.
You do maintenance as well?
Yeah, let me see. That sounds familiar. Yes. No, not really. I did the log work and everything.
Do you have your third class license?
Is that the least?
Yes.
Yes, that's the one I had.
Now, there is a misconception. You do not have to have a license to be a disc jockey. A lot of people think you do. The reason some disc jockeys have a license is that they become combo men, and they are licensed
to
turn the station on and off, the carrier, and to take the readings, and that's what they're licensed for. But just to talk, that's no license required, except if you're Mel Tillis, and he practically needs a license.
Letters, photographs and memories of you. Hoping somehow I'll feel better, and when the smoke is gone, I won't want you. And when the smoke is gone, then I'll be free.
Thank you.
That's Mel Tillis with a song he wrote years ago for Raye Price, Mel with Burning Memories. Friends, let me tell you about one of my favorite things. It's the country music newspaper, Music City News, the only major country music publication that comes from Nashville. Every month, you get to read exclusive interviews with country music stars, album reviews, new record releases, behind-the-scenes stories, visit the stars' homes, and there are lots of pictures, but very important, something no other country music publication has, Music City News lists when and where you can get to see future personal appearances of the stars. You too can become a part of the country music scene by subscribing to Music City News. Subscribe now by enclosing your check for $8 and you'll be saving more than 20% off the single copy price. And in addition to that, for acting now, you'll get a baker's dozen. That's 13 issues for the price of 12. So rush your check for $8 today to Ralph Emery, Post Office Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. The first time Susan Raye ever appeared on this show was with Joe Stampley.
Right.
I guess that was the first time you'd met him.
It was.
Have you worked with him since those days?
I haven't ever seen him since then.
Really? He still exists.
My husband worked with him, though, and said he did a beautiful show.
He's an outstanding singer. And Joe's going to sing the next song and show you that I'm right.
There she goes again. She's pretty as a picture. Dancing round and round the floor with someone new. And the band is softly playing. Deep inside me, I keep saying, there she goes again. After all, there she goes again.
There she goes.
She's a special kind of woman. No one knows it like the fool who let go. As my broken heart is sinking, I've been standing here thinking, there she goes again. As pretty as a picture. Oh, there she goes again. She's dancing around the floor.
Joe Stampley singing There She Goes Again.
Folks, this is Susan Raye co-hosting the Ralph Emery Show, and it's my turn to sing again.
Stop the world and let me off. I'm tired of going round and round. I played the game of love and lost. Now stop the world and let me off. My dreams are shattered, don't you see?
'cause you no longer care for me. I miss the wonder of your kiss. How can you leave me here like this? Stop the world and let me off. I'm tired of going round and round. I played the game of love and lost. Now stop the world and let me off. To the ground, the one I love has let me down. I miss the wonder of his kiss. How could he leave me here like this? Stop the world and let me off. I'm tired of going round and round. Game of love and lost. Now stop the world and let me off.
Susan, where did you first hear that song? That has been done by so many people.
I think the version I first heard was Bonnie Owens.
Now, there you've got me. I don't think I had ever heard her version. Patsy Cline used to sing it. Back further than that, Johnny and Jack used to sing it.
Mm-hmm.
The Anglin brothers. They weren't brothers. Johnny and Jack.
That's a different angle.
Johnny Wright and Jack Anglin. And so I guess the song has been around a long time. Waylon Jennings used to sing.
That's, I think the version we did was more closely with his than any other.
I think it was his debut record at RCA, the first one he made, when the world had hardly heard of him. You've heard Susan Raye on this show with Stop the World and Let Me Off. Now, Susan, I'm interested in where you live there with the river in your backyard.
You are?
I want to tell you, I went to Bakersfield on a hurried trip about a year and a half ago to see Merle Haggard. And I'm driving now in downtown Bakersfield.
I know what you're going to say.
And here I come to this bridge. And the bridge says, Kern River. No swimming or no diving. And I look and there's not a drop of water in the river.
That's the river behind our house, yes.
What would you...
We have water.
Huh?
We have water. I don't know what happened. Somewhere on down the line as it goes down towards town, they ran out of water.
Well, how could you have water at your house and no water downtown?
Well, I'm not sure. I think they've obviously stopped the river somewhere.
Well, I heard they diverted it for the crops. Is that right?
I don't know.
Don't you know anything about
it? I never ask.
Huh?
You know, we have water. You know, it's their problem if they don't have any.
But it's a farming area, isn't
true.
It?
True. It's a very, Kern County is the richest county in the world.
What do you mean, rich?
It has,
they can't even afford water.
They make more money.
Huh?
Well, you know, you can't buy water. They have more cotton than any other county in the United States, which I never knew. They have a lot of produce, and they have an awful lot of oil wells.
I imagine it's the oil that makes it the richest county.
Wouldn't hurt.
So Kern County is the richest county in the United States?
Yes.
Really? Kern County, California, north of L.A., about how many miles?
110 miles.
And Bakersfield is the county seat, I guess.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm not there that often, you know. I'm in
and out.
Y'all
remind me not to book a dummy next time. Don't you know anything about where you live, Susan?
Well, I'm not there very often. I'm taking care of five kids you got to keep in mind there.
Okay.
I don't wander around town and say, is this the county seat?
Don't you ever have to buy a license?
I send someone else, you know.
Okay. Bring on this fella right here.
This fellow here?
Yes.
Conway Twitty is next.
Play. Guitar play. Take me back to yesterday. Let me me see cotton growing in the field. Let me hear my mama calling, look a yonder, y'all who's coming down the road. He's coming home, but they know I never will. Before I go, we got time for one more song.
One more song,
then we'll have to move along. Another town, another crowd. Lord, I wonder if they know. Can they read between the lines in my song? As I sing about a good boy that went wrong. We got years to kill. We got to climb that distant hill. I wonder if they think of me.
Guitar play.
You're so precise when you when you identify the singers.
Yes.
That was Conway Twitty with Play Guitar Play. When someone in our house has a cold or flu and wants relief from the aches and fever, it's Rest, Fluids, and Bayer Aspirin. In my parents' house, it was Rest, Fluids, Bayer Aspirin. In my grandparents' house, it was Rest, Fluids, Bayer Aspirin. Isn't it amazing? In over 60 years, medical science hasn't been able to improve upon aspirin. Three generations of doctors have recommended it. Bayer was the first aspirin, and today Bayer is still number one. Use only as directed. We are trying to get a few answers out of Susan Ray. I want to go back to your house again.
Yes.
You have a new house on the river.
Yes.
Does your family like to fish?
My husband likes to fish, and so the boys do, but I try not to let them as much as I can.
Is it possible just go out in the backyard to the rear of the lot, I suppose?
Right.
Well, how big is your lot?
10 acres.
Okay, a little mini farm there.
Right.
And you just throw a line in, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Let's see, I think the biggest fish they caught was about 15-inch trout.
Okay. You like to fish?
No.
I never have heard people describe fish in inches. Usually they say,
oh, really?
It's a pound, you know, or 2 pound or 4 pounds. Or
not in California and Oregon, they don't. I liked to fish when I was a little girl. My grandfather used to take me out fishing, but now I find that I have too many other things to do, and I sit there and think about all the other things I should be doing.
All right, you keep talking about how busy you are. What do you do all the time? What do you do all day if you're home?
Ralph, if you had 5 sons, you wouldn't say that. I get up at 6:30, unless the baby gets me up earlier, and get the 3 older boys off to school. I feed the baby and give him a bath. We do probably 4 or 5 loads of laundry a day. I iron, a considerable amount.
You wait a minute.
I cook.
You stars don't do your own ironing, do you?
Well, let me put it this way. I have never seen anybody run in and say, oh, let me do your ironing for you. You know, it just hasn't happened yet. I do my own ironing, yes.
Yeah, I imagine you keep the washing machine going all the time, don't you?
Yes, we do. It's, you know, and there's a lot of cooking. My son, my four-year-old likes to bake with me. You know, Mommy, are we going to make cookies today? And makes a mess out of things. It's
all right, now with all this going on when you're at home, what's going on right now that you're in Nashville or whenever you're singing somewhere?
I'm afraid to ask.
When you get home, are the dishes piled
well,
up?
Well, my husband was telling me last night that he had a lot of problems. He said, I'm having my mother come over tonight to help me because Jeanette, our babysitter, was going to a baby shower. And I said, it's really rough being a mother, isn't it, dear? And he said, I can't do anything. He said, I can't get anything done when I have to take care of all five of the children, which, you know, he has help usually, but she's going out tonight.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Babysitter's going out and the dishes
yes.
are getting dirtier, aren't they? Miss Donna Fargo, another recent guest on the show, is going to sing that little twiddly-dee song. You ever sing this? Twiddly-dee, twiddly-dee-dee.
Seems like I have somewhere back through the years.
Mockingbird Hill.
Twiddly-dee-dee-dee-dee. It gives me a thrill.
La, 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 la.
To wake up in the morning.
Wake up
to the mockingbird's trill. Tra-la-la,
tra-la, twiddly-dee-dee.
When the sun in the morning peeps over the hill and kisses the roses round my windowsill, then my heart fills with gladness when I hear the trill of the birds in the treetops on Mockingbird Hill. Tra-la-la,
tra-la,
twiddly-dee-dee. It gives me a thrill to
wake up
in the morning,
wake up
to the mockingbird's trill. Tra-la-la,
tra-la,
twiddly-dee-dee. There's peace and good
luck.
You're welcome as the flowers on Mockingbird Hill. In the evening, I climb up the hill and survey all my kingdom while everything's still. Only me and the sky and an old whippoorwill singing songs in the twilight on
Mockingbird Hill.
Tra-la-la,
tra-la,
twiddly-dee-dee-dee. It gives me a thrill to
wake up
in the morning,
wake up
to the mockingbird's trill. Tra-la-la,
tra-la,
twiddly-dee-dee. There's peace and goodwill. You're welcome as the flowers on
Mockingbird Hill.
Donna Fargo with Mockingbird Hill. All right, Susan, at this point, you take over. Do anything you want to.
Anything I want?
Yes.
Well, we'll throw out the list here. And could you bring in some extra musicians and music? And, well, let's see.
You've been doing that all day. I wouldn't think you'd want to do that.
No, I would just as soon sit back and relax and listen to Charlie Rich sing about that easy look.
She's got the easy look. Any time you're for every man to see. that easy look belongs to me. She sits there at the bar, her feelings standing bare, open as the see-through dress she always wears. She's got that come-on look, her eyes an open book. She knows I know, but I don't think she really cares. She's got that easy look that any time you're ready kind of easy look. She wears that look for every man to see. Lord, it's killing me, 'cause that woman with that easy look belongs to me. That woman with that easy look belongs to me.
Charlie Rich. I don't hear the term silver fox as much. You know, we are all victims of fads. And a year ago or 2 years ago, all you heard was the silver fox.
Anyone who wanted to act like they knew him well said, oh, yeah, the old silver fox and I, yes.
What was it you heard about Carmel Taylor? Carmel Taylor is a fella from Alabama, fine songwriter and singer.
Yes, well, I did one of his songs today, and he was telling me that, funny he should mention this when you call me Miss Lovely all the time. He was to do a show, and for a week ahead of time, they kept saying, and don't forget, next week we'll have the lovely Miss Carmel Taylor. Then he came in.
Okay. All right. Surprise came in singing, surprise.
Yeah.
You've heard Charlie Rich sing Easy Look. Ever stop to think what you did before they invented the 4x4 pickup truck? You probably got stuck a lot. That can happen up there on the mountain or when you're out hunting, fishing, or camping. That's why you want a tough, reliable 4x4 like Ford makes. The new 77 Ford four-wheel drives are out, and there's something else. Heavy-duty half-tonners, three-quarter-ton pickups. They all run on any kind of gas, leaded, unleaded, even tractor gas. For 77, all Ford V8 4x4s give you a choice of full-time or part-time four-wheel drive. They're tough trucks, made even tougher this year with increased rust and corrosion protection. And to give you the extra muscle of V8 power, new high-efficiency 351 and 400 V8 options to choose from. 77's the time to go 4x4 from Ford. 93 out of 100 of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years are still on the job. And that's what you want in a 4x4, toughness. Come in and drive a tough 4x4 bargain at your Ford dealers now. All right, lovely, it's your turn to sing, and the last time you were on this show, this was your latest record.
Right.
A hit where?
A hit?
Wasn't this a hit in New Zealand?
Oh, well, it was a record in New Zealand before it was released in the States.
But it turned out to be a cute little record for you. You got a dog at your house?
Yes.
Got one for each boy?
No, we only have three.
Oh, you got to pick up a couple of dogs on the way home.
At least.
Jerry just called, said, have Susan pick up a couple of dogs on the way home. Here's Susan Raye.
What you gonna do with a dog like that? He ain't no good, and that's a well-known fact. I'd run him off, but he'd just come back. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? That man of mine, he's a no-good thing.
He went downtown and hawked my wedding ring. Spent all the money before he got back. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? We've got 6 kids and 1 on the way. He lays around the house and he sleeps all day. Always wanting me to scratch his back. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? What you gonna do with a dog like that? He ain't no good and that's a well-known fact. I'd run him off but he'd just come back. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? Stubbed his toe and fell through the door. Broke all my dishes chasing the cat. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? The roof needs fixing and it's starting to rain. The car won't start, there's no gasoline. He's got me living in this rundown shack. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? What you gonna do with a dog like that? He ain't no good and that's a well-known fact. I'd run him off but he'd just come back. Now what you gonna do with a dog like that? What you gonna do with a dog like that?
Our guest Susan Raye with What You Gonna Do With a Dog Like That. All right, Miss Susan Raye, it is time to say goodbye until tomorrow.
Goodbye until tomorrow.
See you, lovely. Our show presented by the Ford folks who have those dependable Ford trucks, and by Bayer Aspirin for that mean old headache you might have, or that old cold that might have crept up on you. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you.